In the past, I've talked about the 1987 Ninja Turtles animated series. Now it's time I talk about the 2003 series. Let us begin. When I was 18 years old, I saw this commercial with the TMNT letters and I thought to myself, oh please don't tell me they're airing it in reruns. I mean, didn't they cancel it after going on for 10 seasons? But wait. This one was way different from the 80s cartoon. This was a Ninja Turtle series I've never seen before, and it made me want to glue myself to a couch or a chair or whatever to see if it's better than the old series. And it was! Now, about the 2003 series, it was produced by 4Kids. Yes, the company that was known for ruining anime like... yeah. Anyway, the current TMNT cartoon was identical to its comic book counterpart. It was darker, had more action, better animation, more serious, and that's about it. However, this show got bashed and criticized by the 1987 elitists. Why? Simple. Because it's nothing like they grew up with. So what? Now, besides talking about the characters, which is very important, instead, I'm going to compare both the show and the comics, plus the movie as well. So let us start with the first episode, shall we, folks? Things changed. In the very beginning, when the turtles were fighting the purple dragons, you'll notice Leonardo's narration is closer to the lines of the comics.
My name is Leonardo, and right now, my brothers and I are in a mess of trouble. Our backs are up against the wall in some trash-strewn alley.
I also noticed two police officers look exactly like Kevin Eastman and Peter Laird, as brief cameos. There's a scene where Michelangelo was about to say,
"Cowabunga!"
He almost said it. Plus, the foot ninjas appeared as well, and no, they're not robots like in the 80s series. That's good. A better mousetrap. This is where we get to see Baxter Stockman, the scientist who built the Mousers, and April O'Neil, his lab assistant, just like in the comics. And yes, Baxter tries to kill April. I notice a canister Leonardo picked up says TCRI, the same ooze that mutated them in Splinter. In the second film, they only changed one letter, don't know why. They also used that name in the 2012 series on Nickelodeon, which is the Krang's hideout. Attack of the Mousers. April meets the Turtles for the first time, and we get to see the origin, which we've heard it 100 times already. Also, Michelangelo says cowabunga in the flashback when he was very young.
Cowabunga!
Plus, we get to see Eastman and Laird again, and Hun makes an appearance as well. Oh, I forgot to tell you that in the show, Baxter works for the Shredder, but in the comics, he doesn't. Meet Casey Jones. This is where we get to see our favorite vigilante, Casey Jones himself. We even get to see a flashback of Casey as a kid when Hun and the Purple Dragons torched his father's store. This episode was also based off the one-off micro series, which involves Raphael. Darkness on the edge of town. The foot ninjas have stolen an 11th century Japanese sword that could locate artifacts. It can also shoot out energy waves, and I have to say, that's a really cool yet kick-ass sword. Then there's the two-episode arc, The Shredder Strikes. Splinter explains the story about Oroku Saki, aka The Shredder, which I'm sure you folks are familiar with that story, right? Splinter was a pet of Hamato Yoshi, learning the art of ninjutsu. In the comics, Shredder kills both Tang Shen and Yoshi. In the 2003 series, he only killed Yoshi. No, not that Yoshi, this Yoshi.
Finish him!
Anyway, if you ever watched the first movie, Splinter scratches Saki. In this one, they switched it to Hun. In part 2, we see the Shredder in action, and let me tell ya, he is badass. Way better than the 1987 Shredder. Now, I love the 80s Shredder, except I prefer how he was in the first season, aka the first 5 episodes, instead of how he was in the other 6 seasons. But in seasons 8 and 10 of the Red Sky episodes, he was very evil again. The scenes with the Turtles fighting Shredder and the Foot Clan is frickin' awesome, which was taken from the comics and the movie as well. If you ever read the original comics, Shredder pulls out a grenade, Donatello throws his bow staff, knocking him off the rooftop until the grenade exploded. In the film, Splinter flips Shredder over, making him fall into the trash compactor. And in the 2003 series, it's different. Then you got the 3-episode arc, Notes from the Underground, which is an interesting story arc. I noticed the voices of the scientists were done by Mike Pollock, who did Dr. Eggman on Sonic X.
Underground. Our foot soldiers have been unable to locate them, so the genetic division has been directed to mutate human subjects so that they can explore deeper into the Earth.
After their underground adventure, the Foot Ninja are now in the sewers locating the Turtles, so they have no choice but to live in April's apartment. In the 2-episode arc, guess who comes back?
No.
That's right, folks. Shredder has returned. But how did he survive from the fallen water tower? I mean, no human could survive that. Could it be that Shredder's indestructible like the Super Shredder? Or maybe he's immortal? Anyway, it begins with Leonardo starting his morning exercise until he ended up fighting against the Foot Clan, Hun, and Shredder's elite guards. These episodes were based off the one-off micro-series involving Leonardo. In the original comics and the movie, Casey Jones shows up, but in this one...
Now that's what I call crashing a party.
Now is that an entrance or is that a freaking entrance? Anyway, after their huge battle, the entire antique store goes up in flames. The next episode picks up where it left off. The Turtles, Splinter, April, and Casey live in Casey's grandmother's house. And no, Donatello and Casey do not insult each other in this show. But at least it had Michelangelo say suck.
Oh, man, it sucks being cold-blooded.
Whoa, hey, butted! Did he just say suck?
Yeah, he said suck.
Yeah, this is pretty cool.
This show kicks ass. The best episodes was the 3-episode story arc Return to New York. The Turtles along with Splinter head into Shredder's building battling against the Foot Clan, Shredder's clones from the comics, the 5 mystic elemental ninjas, Shredder's elite guards, Hun, Shredder himself, and Baxter Stockman in a cyborg suit, complete with missile launchers, a machine gun, an extendable hand, a flamethrower. Man, this guy's got everything. Plus, he betrays the Shredder as well.
And didn't suspect a thing, you pompous, overblown ignoramus.
The scene with Leonardo and Shredder is cinematic. They jump, and... Whoa! Let's see that again. Did Leonardo just cut off Shredder's head?
You're joking.
I am not making this up. He actually did. Man, 4Kids had some serious balls, I tell ya. After their humongous battle, the Turtles find Splinter is missing and now they have to search for him. However, this show does have some references to the 1987 series, like Michelangelo's
No More Cowabunga!
Okay, geez, Raphael, I won't say it. You don't have to be an ass about it. Though, there was an episode where April is wearing a yellow jumpsuit with a number 9 that's actually a 6. There's another episode where Gen cosplays as Rocksteady. In Lone Raff and Cub, Tyler's mom resembles Irma without the bushy ponytail. And there was yet another episode where an Utrum was named Krang, but it was a joke. Well, this wraps up my review on the 2003 cartoon. And to close, this is the best Ninja Turtles animated series I've ever seen. I would like to explain about the other seasons, but instead I just want to talk about the first season. The show did go downhill with Fast and Forward and Back to the Sewers, and I didn't like those two, only seasons 1 through 5. And yes, I have seen the 25th anniversary film Turtles Forever, where the current Turtles meet the 1987 Turtles and the Mirage Turtles. The movie did have flaws, but it was rather enjoyable. Well, I hope you enjoyed my special review for reaching 200 subscribers. Perhaps when I get 200 more, I'll come out with another special review. So until then, as always, I shall see you all next time.
Turtles, there's no one better.
Watch out for Shredder!